Joey, and I'm a huge geek. Huge.
Whoever he finds, he's got to be able to bring back home to Ma.
As far as she's concerned, like, any woman in my life is a threat.
What kind of girl are you going to find at Comic-Con? We are girls go there.
Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God.
I just want to find a girl who isn't my mother.
It doesn't matter if she's a virgin.
You know, the one thing I can consistently say about speed dating is the odds are really good, but the goods are still really kind of odd.
Geek Love is being with someone who doesn't think you're weird.
There's power!
Over 18?
Yep.
Single?
Very.
Spiders?
As an attraction or as just something to admire or collect? Or...
whatever you do with your women is not my business.
Okay. So this is my room, or what I like to refer to as my very geeky man cave. I'm Joey, I'm 25. This is my fourth time going to Comic-Con, but my first time looking for love there. I have right now the Xbox 360, the PS3, I have a Wii. I have a Wii. The three words that best describe me are probably geeky, ridiculous, and lonely. One was to say that I have a relationship with video games, then I definitely cheated on Super Mario with Sonic the Hedgehog. He's like the blue seductress who takes me out into the night and does wonderful things to me. I love women, everything about women, yeah. Women are great. They're so sensitive and wonderful, and they have soft hair and soft skin. It's great, I love women. I have Thor's hammer. I never smite on the first date. I'm not that kind of guy. I think that my trouble lies with finding a girl who matches in terms of both personality, you know, geekdom. Like, I need to find the perfect girl, if she exists. My mom is a bit torn about sci-fi speed dating. Would you want me to find, like, a nice girl to bring home?
I don't think that's the place to find a nice girl.
On one hand, she wants me to be happy. She wants me to find love.
What kind of girl are you gonna find at Comic-Con?
The kind of girl who...
weird girls go there.
On the other hand, my mom likes me where I am right now, living at home with her. So as far as she's concerned, like, you know, any woman in my life is a threat. What exactly do you think these girls are doing? Do you know that instead of doing drugs and drinking, they're reading comic books?
Who knows what they're doing between pages, okay?
Between
Joe,
pages?
Joe,
like, oh,
Joe.
Let me turn a page and let me smoke a little bit of something.
No,
and
then
all day they are playing and they are learning.
No.
And
you're
good
wrong.
Good wife. And all day play together. So nice.
I'm not looking for much. I just want to find a girl who will give me hugs and kisses and isn't my mother.
I love you, Joey.
I love you too.
I want the best for you.
Always.
Most of the people I've dated have been geeks. All the people I've dated have been geeks.
Geeks have an understanding of the fantasy world that normal people don't. The fantasy is what makes it real.
Geek love.
The success rate we're having with Sci-Fi Speed Dating is pretty good. We're at one married couple, 10 engagements, and up to 50 couples dating seriously.
Come on in, guys.
I feel anxious, nervous. I don't know exactly what I'm going to find. Hopefully, I will exit not being alone.
Gentlemen, treat the ladies with respect. Ladies, do not use this as a perfection on your friend zone technique, okay? Don't practice that shit here.
So we've got Joey. Hasn't had a lot of dating success. He has trouble finding girls if he can't bring back home to Ma.
The dates are 3 minutes long. Every 3 minutes, guys, you're gonna follow the arrows on the floor. Do you understand?
My expectations today, I'm trying to set them as low as possible because basically I do not want to set myself up for failure.
Everybody deserves to have fun at Sci-Fi Speed Dating, so enjoy yourselves. Unless you're Klingon, leave. All right.
Speed dating begins in a couple seconds.
3, 2, 1,
go. Sit in front of any guy you like.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I am the nefarious number 22.
Oh, that's my favorite number. This is perfect.
No, you're just saying things.
That was my sports number in school. Did you play any sports in high school?
No, I was the most unathletic person in the world.
Really?
Yeah, I had asthma, or at least my mom believed that I had asthma as a kid. So she basically like was like, don't go out. It's scary out there.
Why are you a Comic-Con?
Why wouldn't I be a Comic-Con?
I mean, like, what are you here for? Games, comics, movies, everything.
Everything. I don't know what it is, but like something inside my brain is just like,
oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, all right.
So you're a big video game fan?
Yes. This is a good stress reliever when I'm like ready to kill somebody, just nope, gonna shoot zombies all day. We had a lot of the same interests, but he was also like interested in everything, kind of like I am. He was really sweet.
Are your ears moving?
yeah, nickel maybe. You know the brainwave ears?
That's a thing? Jesus Christ. I see that you also have ears. Do you like think like certain thoughts and like they just start moving?
I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm just really nervous.
It's really hard to tell who would bring home to mom. Just because they're all in costume right now, I feel like you generally know what you're gonna get into even before the conversation begins. It's kind of weird how that works. I have a great polar bear joke that ends with an icebreaker.
Okay, go for it.
That's it. It's right there. Gotcha.
On the next date, please.
So, Doctor Who?
Oh my god.
Yeah,
what was that? Yes. I was so excited to like dress up as a doctor. And everyone's gonna think I'm like the professor or something. Not the doctor.
Well, I mean, that's true. Like, you just walk down the street and like, oh, there goes that professor with her bow tie.
Where's she going? It's Saturday. I thought he was adorable. He was sweet. And I was like comfortable talking to him. Comic-Con is like a time warp.
It is. Time warp.
Wibbly wobbly, timey wimey.
The Doctor Who girl definitely seemed very warm and very kind and very beautiful blue eyes. So are you supposed to be the Aunt Jemima Captain America? Sorry, I just see the apron. You're supposed to be the burger chef.
Yes!
Yes!
You're the first person.
Am I really?
Yes, Louise!
Jesus, thank God someone just like decided to just like bust that out. She's, you know, kind of seemed, you know, cute.
What are you into?
Everything. Star Wars, comic books, you know, sci-fi movies, video games, that kind of stuff. How about you?
I play D&D a lot with my friends.
You said D&D, right?
Yeah.
I've always wanted to play D&D. Are you ever the Dungeon Master?
Actually, no, because it's too hard.
Quiet, silencio.
Shut your pie holes.
Gentlemen, you're gonna stand up, you're gonna come over to this table. Ladies, you're gonna stand up, you're gonna go to that table. Go, run, now. Been keeping score on your scorecards, okay? You're gonna find the pieces of paper on the table that correspond to the people you like. All right, go.
It's actually all the giant blur right now. Thank God that they let you make notes because, like, it's just a lot to take in.
Joey nails it. Every girl writes their number on his paper. He came out swinging, he was given roses. It looks like he's pretty solid to get a perfect match.
Gentlemen, when you are done, you will have a seat.
Okay, ladies.
At this point in time, you're gonna head over there and grab the pieces of paper that have your number on it. Quick run. Please ensure that you have the correct piece of paper.
Damn. Oh,
actually, I'm on 5. That's kind of crazy. I'm feeling pretty great.
All right, ladies. I kind of need you to spread out in front here. Now, this is a competition. You need to be fast. That's the key, okay?
The Doctor Who girl is absolutely amazing and a very beautiful girl. Now I'm actually starting to get a little bit nervous.
Find your perfect match.
So Joey got his eye on Doctor Who, and there's a good chance she likes him. The problem is every girl wants him.
Whoever gets to him first wins. Go, find your perfect match.
You're very fast.
Yeah, I run a lot.
Quick.
So you come here often?
Actually, yeah. So only my second time, but yeah.
I will say that I had someone else in mind, the Doctor Who girl, actually. But I also like this girl, too. Maybe the Doctor Who girl was just the one who's got the best first impression.
Like, a perfect date for me would just be cooking and then sitting around, like, kicking each other's butts in Mario Kart, so.
I completely missed the entire cooking part, maybe because I'm a guy. So I'm just, like, just kicking butts in Mario Kart.
No, actually, I like cooking. I don't get a feminist thing out of it. It's not like, oh my god, I won't cook for you. It's like, I like cooking, so I'll do it.
Right. She loves to cook, so, yeah, that's definitely the two qualities that I think I'm looking for. A girl who plays video games and a girl who's domesticated, so I can bring her home to mom. Well, I mean, if you're into video games and everything like that, I mean, like, I've got lots of video games back at my place and a comfortable couch. How about this weekend?
Okay.
Playing video games. I don't know, it may seem awkward as a first date, but I'm actually gonna have her meet mom and come back to my place. Everyone's gonna be so jealous of us.
How are you?
Good to hear.
Tired, but it's Comic-Con,
hey.
So.
Okay. I'm not sure if this will be my most awkward first date, but all signs say that yes, it will.
Hi, welcome.
Hi.
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
You too, I'm Emily.
Hi.
Meeting the parents on a first date was a little bit weird, but, you know, we'll see.
Beautiful.
So you like to play video games?
I am a gamer, yes.
Oh, wow. I have some food here for you.
Just a bottle of water would be nice, actually.
A bottle of water? Okay, here.
Thank you.
So, Emily, are you originally from New York?
No, I'm not. I'm from Delaware. I'm just up here for college.
Oh, where do you go?
I go to Columbia.
Oh, great. Ivy League. Wow.
We're actually just going to go and play some video games. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's just go.
You never know.
Uh-huh. Oh, you have the most sensual screech of a heartbeat.
I hate it when you get the long ones, you don't know where to put it.
Right? This would probably be a very easy way to get friend-zoned, to play video games on a first date.
Ha! I think video games are actually a great way to loosen up. I am hoping, and I think it's going to turn into something a little bit more romantic, but, you know, we'll see. It's only the first date.
I want to apologize in advance for what's about to happen.
Oh, shoot.
What? Yep.
How did that even...
Yep. You 1 second, and that's all that matters.
Out of two.
Yay!
You don't want an empanada off the road?
I'm good, but thank you. They look delicious.
Are you leaving already?
Yeah, I have midterms to study for. I'm so sorry. Yep. It's great to meet you. Thank you.
Same here. Bye-bye.
You can come play.
Okay.
I don't
sounds
even have
good.
To be here.
Take
Bye.
Care.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Good luck.
Very pretty girl.
Forget the old culture, whatever you think. This is United States of America, free country.
Okay. I don't know exactly what that means.
Coming from your father, it means it doesn't matter if she's a virgin.
I love watching and seeing the people connect. Just because they weren't fast enough during the perfect match doesn't mean anything. So Joey's playing the game here. After the date with the perfect match,
he
finds the Doctor Who girl's interested in and sets up another date.
You picked me, I picked you.
I didn't like get over to your class enough.
Yeah. No, I mean, if you're interested, like we can drink coffee or do something.
Why not? Definitely, I'd love that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I actually have a second date to come out of Comic-Con Speed Dating.
I'm Ari, by the way.
I'm Joey. So I'm not really too sure what to expect, probably because never really had a date at Comic-Con. But I mean, what's more romantic than the Javits Center? Did you see that?
No, I didn't.
The KFC guy that was like one of the Avengers.
I was too busy watching Spider-Man doing ballet. Did you see that?
No, I missed it. One of us is talking, the other one's like, oh my god, this is the most amazing thing ever. We definitely had a good time. She's still really into Doctor Who and whatnot. Like, I think she told me that she bought a plushie today that talks. I think there's definitely a very good chance that I will see her again.
Okay, how many people can say that? One of my first dates, I went out with like Peter Parker.
Right?
How cool is that? You don't have the face, the mask?
No, I do.
You have to put it on.
You can't make me put this on.
Please.
No. Okay, only because you've got a great smile. I'm gonna try putting it on.
Because you're kind of cute like that.
Oh, thank you.
I'm excited to get to know him. He seems really nice, interesting, super smart. It kind of helps that he's cute.
I figure maybe we'll go find crime and I'll put on my mask and you can watch me fight while you sit there and look pretty. I really can't say right now who I would choose between the two girls, but you know, Geek Love is great. It's the best thing to happen to my love life.
I'm a lucky girl.
I do it all. Hey, it's me, Joey. And what speed dating at Comic-Con taught me was that, you know, it's very hard to bring girls over the house to introduce them to my mom or to hang out here at my house if my mom's going to basically be questioning whether or not they're virgins or what their motives are with me or anything like that. And so basically what this entire experience taught me is that it's time to move out. And so I'm basically in the process of moving out into my own apartment, so that's exciting, where I will be able to, you know, bring a girl over and play Tetris and not have to worry about my mom coming in and serving us Tang and snacks.